Hey everyone, today we are here at Canberra Airport. These are our first two planes for the day. The one is a Beechcraft Bonsai, I believe. This one has three blades as well. Most of them are usually two-bladed propellers. So it's a piston prop, as you can hear. That's the first one. Time for the second one. Beechcraft Bonsai, I believe it's called. I think that's how you pronounce the name. Those are the first two done. There's a McDonnell Douglas MD95, also known as, now known as the 717, made by Boeing. And we have a Jetstar A320 in the background there. And another Qantas Link Boeing 717, which look a lot like the Fokker 100. Not gonna lie. That's about it for now, and I'll see you guys in a bit. Not to mention there is the Prime Minister's plane over there, which is a Boeing 737. So yeah, I'll see you guys in a bit. This is the Victor Air Tour. Sneaky little airplanes these ones are. Here comes another one. Well, it is a pretty nice day for it, to be honest. So fair enough that a lot of these little guys will be flying around. This one's another Beechcraft Bonsai. one looks like a Vans aircraft. I assume they're using the smaller runway. These two. Yep, there it is. This one is possibly a 737. Either Virgin or Rex. So if we'll wait for her to get a little bit closer, and we'll watch the landing. Yep, definitely a turbofan engine aircraft. Probably a Rex or Virgin Australia 737. The tail does have a bit of blue on it, so my best guess is probably Rex. And it is Rex. So we have a Rex. So it's a Rex Boeing 737-800. Here comes Qantas Link 717, MD95, McDonnell Douglas, and there's that little Acrobat plane. It's usually a turbofan engine being at the back. It has to be a T-tail aircraft, as you can see. First commercial departure for the day, and first commercial landing for the day. Turbofan 2 should be starting up pretty soon. In fact, I'm pretty sure it's already started. You need it running. Now it's number one, engine number one's turn to start up. So usually number two starts up first and then it's number one. You can hear the engines spooling up. So it's now taxiing to what I believe is runway 35. The name of this runway, from what I've known. I'm not good on runways, but I'm definitely all right with aircrafts when it comes to knowing the names and everything. Checking the tail rudder. These are being retired at the end of the year. You see the mirage coming from the exhaust of the engine. I think one of the small private jet has landed or something as well from over there. We go. There's a lot more to come soon, so better embrace myself because there's a lot more planes landing and taking off. I would assume Jetstar is going to be next. Rightio, so here comes another one. This one looks like a Qantas Link Embraer E190. Yep. lost. That's the second landing done. Rightio, so here comes a de Havilland Canada Dash 8 Q300. Haven't seen one of those here for a while now, actually. Not gonna lie. This one probably is a Virgin Australia, I think. Or is it another Qantas Link Embraer? Yep. This aircraft here will use this taxiway like it always does. I really am hoping for it this time, because that's such a rare aircraft to land here, man. So these are Pratt & Whitney turboprops. Forgot the name of the model of what engine it is, but it's definitely, but I know the maker's a Pratt & Whitney. So yeah, we'll wait for the turboprops to switch off. It's not like the turbofans, you can actually see the engine, the propeller, basically. You can see the movement. There we go. The turboprops are switching off. So that's the Q300 arrival. So there's not much going on so far, so I'll see you guys in a bit. Rightio, so here comes a Virgin Australia, Boeing 737-800. As you can see here. So you have the turbofan engines spinning. I'm not sure if you can see that little spiral inside. So we'll wait for that to take off, and hopefully one of the Jetstars, one of the Qantas planes will be taking off pretty soon. I'm not sure, probably Jetstar I think. Probably even the Rex as well. So yeah, we'll wait for her to take off. Rightio, so they're now lining up for the runway. And here we go. So here comes a little piston prop. Wait for that little piston prop to take off now. There's two of them actually. There's one down there as well. Which looks like a Cessna. Yep, that one there is definitely a Cessna. But yeah. Perfect timing. So that aircraft there unexpectedly took off from this runway. The little Cessna. And this little guy's next. She's off. Radio, so here comes Rex with their Boeing 737-800. And the Royal Australian Air Force with their Boeing 737-800, by the looks of it. Or 700, I don't know. We'll compare the two when they taxi past, but yep, definitely a 700. 700s are way, way shorter. Which means this is an 800. That's what REX stands for. Regional Express. So we'll wait for it to take off. Rightio, so here comes the RAF Boeing 737-700. Now lining up for the runway. Yet again, we are comparing the two aircrafts. By the looks of it, with the size, you can see. They're exactly the same, but I've noticed at the top of the tail on this one here is a little bit different than the commercial one. so much power in those engines.
Damn.
So yeah, we'll wait for that one to take off. So yeah, I'll see you guys in a bit. Rightio, so the Dash 8 Q300 is almost ready for departure. Oh, I can hear one turboprop going. The pushback should be happening pretty soon. Go. And turboprop number one is starting now as well. Maybe it'll use the taxiway next to me. I'd really appreciate that, to be honest. That would definitely make my day. Because overall, it is my favourite aircraft. Yeah, so we'll wait for the aircraft to start taxiing, and I'll see you guys in a bit. So the aircraft has now been uncoupled to the pushback tug. Yeah, she's off. Got some Embraers that are now departing. Rightio, so here come two Embraers. Both in Qantas Link colours. by the looks of it, three takeoffs. I'm actually not sure what aircraft this is, to be honest. Well, that's today's episode. Hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys next episode. Goodbye.